It's the last 14 fights of a ferocious MIMMA Season 2. Who will go on to the contender fights?
That's right. But first up, the first heavyweight semi-final between Muhammad Zulhanizam and Muhammad Noor Shaiful. Let's go!
It was more than a training affair between these two good friends. Ijam was the more active of the two heavyweights, as he knew that Noor Shaiful was more dangerous standing up. But as much as he tried, Ijam could not find a way to close the fight. As the bell rang at the end of the first round, there was still much to do for both of these fighters. The second round saw more aggression between the two, and Ijam was equal to every strike that Noor Shaiful initiated. At one point, Noor Shaiful managed to catch Ijam in a leg lock, but he somehow managed to get free. But as the round ended, it was a stalemate all over again. The final round, and Ijam took his chance as well, as he looked again to keep the game on the ground. Noor Shaiful's defense was sound, but was lacking in finishing skills, perhaps knowing that he was fighting his friend. But Ijam was the more aggressive of the two, scoring on the takedown and managed to keep his opponent locked for a moment. Again, Noor Shaiful was able to free himself, but the question was, did he score enough points in the match? Tiredness crept in as the bigger of the two fighters was unable to finish off his moves, and Ijam took advantage of that. As the bell rang, the outcome would be uninspiring, to say the least. To much surprise, Ijam took the win. Both fighters were pumped up for the fight and were both aggressive from the start. As they let their fists do the talking, it was T-Jack Yo who scored the first points, which rocked Q-Tech Guan to the ground. Although he seemed to be getting a severe beating, Tech Guan did not give up as he looked to find a way out of his situation. But T-Jack Yo continued to pour on the beating as he landed some powerful straight punches. But just when it seemed lost, Tech Guan came out fighting and gave as good as he got from Jack Yo. It was apparent then that Tech Guan tried to take the game to the ground, but the taller Jack Yo was more dominant standing up. But as the fight went on, Tech Guan became desperate and tried another takedown, and if it wasn't for the end of the first round, this fight would have been over. The second round began as earnest as the first, and again, both fighters looked to keep their first round game plan. Again, Tech Guan seemed too eager to close the match, but was caught by his opponent. But strength is one of Tech Guan's skills, as he reversed and scored some vital points. This time, as Jack Yo tired, Tech Guan slowed the pace down and was measured with his strikes at his opponent. As the end of the round came to an ear, you could tell that exhaustion was setting in for Jack Yo. This was now a battle of stamina, and Tech Guan knew that this was his round to make amends for the first. As he attacked, it was obvious that Jack Yo was not able to counter as he did before, and Tech Guan took full advantage of that. By holding top position and scoring reshots from the scrambles, Tech Guan did a good job of keeping the pressure on T-Jack Yo. And whilst Jack Yo tried to muster some defense, it was the shorter Tech Guan who used his strength to score more vital points. Tech Guan did a good job of securing the fight by using his cage control and his utter strength to apprehend Jack Yo. And as the match ended, it was a unanimous decision by the judges, and Tech Guan will have his chance for a title.
Well impressed, but congratulations to all the organizers. First time I've been to one of these events, seen snippets on TV, but you can see there's a lot of enthusiasm. It's fantastic for Malaysia. Fantastic, Malaysia's leading the way in this amateur tournament. We're one of the best in the world, and great for ASEAN. So thrilled to be here. Thrilled to see the amount of enthusiasm from the fighters and the kind of community you guys have built here.
Two islanders looking for glory in this massive bout. As the round began, it was the taller Wong Ang Wui who seemed to have the upper hand. But Stephen Ong was a strong opponent. The Sarawakian was able to free himself, whilst also being the more aggressive of the two. Both fighters were looking to go toe-to-toe here in the first round. Stephen Ong pushed up Wong Ang Wui against the cage and landed some knees and punches out of the clinch. And it was Stephen who rocked Ang Wui to the ground. And as he looked to finish things off, Ang Wui managed to release himself. And as they continued to fight and battle for position, it started to really get technical. Both fighters standing up started to trade big bombs, both landing at a ridiculous pace. The heat turned back on towards the end of the round, as both fighters were matching blow for blow in this fight. Not only did they not stop, it was a cause for concern for their cornermen, but not the excited crowd. And it was going to set up an intriguing second round as the bell rang. It looked like the second round began as the first, with Wang Wei scoring with the double leg takedown. But Steven managed to reverse, and there was no turning back for the Sarawakian this time. With the superior body strength, Steven would continue to dominate. And head judge Olivier Koss had no choice but to stop the match. A TKO victory for the fighter from Sarawak. Muhammad Ayman came into the match with a great submission record and looked to concentrate on the same strategy in this round as he attacked Chin Wei Kuei from the start. Having worked to bring his opponent to the ground, Ayman quickly established the dominant position, and it was only a matter of seconds that he proved why he was a dangerous fighter. An armbar victory and another first round submission for the MIMMA Season 1 finalists. There was no love lost between these two fighters as Mock Judo went straight for the punch after the start. The judo exponent utilized his high kicks to good use and also his strength for the takedown. And a huge double leg for Mock Judo as he began to be dominant with the takedowns of Jason Long. Being aggressive on top, Mock Judo controlled the pace of the fight in the first. It was a game of cat and mouse as the two fighters kept their attacks and defenses up during the ground match, which ended in the first round. The second round saw Jason returning the favor as he looked to start aggressively. He even got a very vicious sweep and took Mock Judo to the ground. But Mock Judo responded well with the double leg and stayed on top of Jason Law, landing some serious ground and pound. And as the round ended, he ended in a dominant position. Jason knew he had to score points in this final round, but Mock Judo was the more determined and stronger of the two fighters. Jason found himself again on the ground and knew that he needed to get out of the situation. But with a strong base, Mock Judo continued his prowess, landing some stiff ground and pound. However, with the final bell gone, it was a foregone conclusion. A victory for Mock Judo and a spot in the contender fight. Two fighters with great technical fighting abilities as they began the round grappling. And Muhammad Rizal used his wrestling to keep Vinod up against the cage. Muhammad Rizal was the more patient of the two fighters as he scored the first points with the takedown. He landed in Dave's guard, and from there he had to land some ground and pound to pass over. However, Vinod worked up and looked for his signature move, the standing guillotine. But Muhammad Rizal was saved by the bell. Vinod came out striking in the second round as he punched and kicked into the restart. But that just played into Rizal's hands. But as Vinod tried to keep the striking game up, Rizal was also up to the challenge with some combos of his own. And it was too close of a fight in the second round. With the final round at stake, Rizal shoots and scored with the takedown and tried to keep the fight on the ground. And he knew that keeping Vinod and working on his punches would ultimately score the points. But the decision was still very close. A split decision result that would end up in Rizal's way. These two fighters were definitely going on the offensive, but Nicholas scored the first points with the takedown. But it proved that both were very effective on the ground, as Masrul demonstrated why he was such a dangerous opponent. It was going to be hard to choose between the two fighters at the end of the second round. Masrul once again tried to keep Nicholas out of reach with his striking in this final round. And again, Nicholas was determined to keep this fight on the ground. Despite the ongoing reversal of positions, it was almost clear that Nicholas was more dominant. He showed his dominance by switching and changing positions, and he did it till the end of the round. And it proved so when the unanimous decision was given to the Sarawakian. This would be the fastest match in the semifinals, as Ben Lee proved to be too strong for Muhammad Azat. Using his longer reach and height, Ben Lee would catch his opponent out, and although he'd taken down, Ben would eventually submit Azat through a guillotine choke to take the win in only 30 seconds. A fight that saw two massive heavyweights with Darren Lowe making the first aggressive move that took down Stephen Yeo. And Darren did not give Stephen any time to recover as he struck quickly at his opponent. It was an anaconda choke that finished him off. A great fight, great camaraderie, and a great win for the gentle giant. It was a case of young versus the veteran as Zhang Yu took on MIMMA's season one fighter. It was Eddie who struck first with a number of body slams that kept Zhang Yu from attacking, not allowing him to escape his position. Finally, Eddie knew that he would have to maintain a standing fight to collect the points, but Zhang Yu was giving it as good as he got up until the final bell. The taller Joshua Q came out of the first round with all cylinders running as he used his height to his advantage. And they began to exchange in the middle of the ring as Joshua landed a takedown and kept the blue belt straight on the ground. There were last-minute attacks back and forth, and despite his strikes, it was a case of a little too late for Kang Fai. Janartan showed his intent with the high kick with the fizzles past Effendi. After seeing his brother lose, Effendi knew he had to win one for the family, and he showed his fast jabs to great effect. Effendi looked to have suffered an injury, and referee Kim Lee Tan was forced to call off the match. It was the policeman Muhammad Hasrul who was the first to react to the bell as he threw in a combination of punches at Lee Kien. But Lee Kien, who was also psyched up for this match and looked to have gotten the takedown. It was two fighters going all out to win almost at all costs. And it seemed Hasrul was the more active of the two as he chased Lee Kien to a standoff. What ensued was a slugfest that delighted the crowd and kept everyone on their feet until the final bell. A great fight between two respectful opponents, but the judges were unanimous in their decision on the winner. After seeing his younger brother lose in the previous round, Nor Ahmed looked forward to this fight. But Aguilon is no easy opponent and quickly showed his strength by clinching Nor Ahmed. It was a mistake that would not only revive memories of his younger brother's loss, but also the end of the journey for himself.
It has been an explosive MIMMA Season 2 semi-final, but who will go on to fight the Season 1 champion?
For that, we'll just have to wait. Catch us next time on MIMMA Contender Fight!